Jason, how are you doing?
I'm doing just fine, man.
Doing all right? You got your stick there?
Yeah, we're back from E3.
Yeah.
Right?
It's a hell of a week.
I need some downtime, so I was just going to play some Street Fighter, actually.
Well, if you just want to relax with some Street Fighter, I would love to join you if you'd like to play against me.
I would like to relax.
Oh, okay.
Play Street Fighter. When I play online, you know, it's fine. You know,
okay.
Competition's good.
We've been friends for a while. I thought maybe we could play. But hey, if you don't want to play with me, that's fine. What if I recommended some competition for you?
Anybody but you is fine.
Even if it's elite competition?
All comers. I'm very casual now.
Oh, okay.
I'm a casual player.
I see. Okay. I'm
not practicing 8 hours a day. I practice 10 minutes every 2 weeks or so, give or take.
Well, we'll see how this goes, because I'm going to bring in the most elite of competition.
Oh.
The leader of Bullet Club in New Japan Pro Wrestling.
Shit.
Jason, I've got Kenny Omega here.
Oh, no.
The cleaner.
Oh, no.
That's right.
Oh,
what a play on words. I'm here. Thank goodness I finally am able to link up with you guys and play some games.
Yeah, we've been trying to set this up for quite a while. Dan has. I'm sorry, Dan. Dan's
yes.
been trying to set this up for quite
yes,
a while. But
yes.
Yeah, I'm glad to have you on board. Looking forward to this. But
yeah, chat a little bit, play some games a little bit.
Kenny, I've seen you play.
You have? You're
really good. And I'm a little intimidated by this. You're at Jabali's house. If you take a look around,
that's right. Yeah,
he's plugging, he's repping his stuff, his big head in the background there.
Yeah, it's a gamer's paradise. I'm actually very envious. Don't tell him I said this, but I'm envious of the place that he's got here.
That Batman's head might actually be bigger than his head, which is quite an astounding feat. But yeah, CEO is going on this weekend down in Florida, one of the premier tournaments in the fighting game scene. This is part of the Capcom Pro Tour as well, so lots of points to be awarded. And did I hear that you're fighting Justin Wong in pools? Did I say something about that?
It may come down to that. I'm not sure how the pools are going to shape up, but we are in the same pool. So if it comes to the point where we both make it near the end, we might face each other.
I believe in you. I believe in you.
You shouldn't. You shouldn't.
I got to root for you. I really.
Yeah.
If you want some like pool style play to prep you, I might be your guy, actually. So. Or maybe Dan would. Maybe Dan would be the guy.
I could jump in after a few, and we'll see if my spam bullshit works. But one of you non-casuals here.
Okay.
I'd like to see who wins out of you two.
Kenny, you'd never know what you're going to fight in pools. So.
Exactly.
But yeah, let's give this a shot here. I'm going to ready up.
Sure.
Oop.
Now I don't actually have a dog in this fight. I don't know who I'm predicting or wanting to win here. I do know one thing though, Kenny. We've got something in common, and that's that we both have gaming rivalries with Xavier Woods. This has been going on for
two.
Yeah, it's been going on for a few years with me and Woods. I beat him at Double Dash at WrestleMania in Silicon Valley, and he has denied it ever since. I beat him in Soul Calibur on a show. He has never beat me at a video game, and yet he loves going on the internet and talking about how he's better than me. So, in the rivalry between you and Woods, I'm definitely Team Kenny Omega here.
It's very much appreciated. Now, the thing is, you can pick me or Woods all you want, but when Woods is dodging, as much as he is, it almost doesn't even make a difference whether you cheer for one or another, because, there's got to be two in this fight.
That's true.
I'm here at CEO. The reason I came here was because I thought I'd be able to meet Woods.
Is he in town?
Okay.
He will be.
Okay.
He will.
Okay. I saw him being cute during the pay-per-view, and a little subtle shout-out to you.
He might duck out at the last minute and go to an anime convention or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I could see him doing that. All right, so we've got, let's see, are you Nash, Jason?
I am Nash, yeah.
Okay. Kenny, have you been disappointed at all in just kind of the lack of support as far as, like, the story mode and the store and everything?
The thing is, like, I understand people's feelings and emotions behind that, but my schedule is so busy with wrestling that sort of it's at a decent enough pace for me to be able to keep up, because I can only really play this game once a week anyway, as it is, so.
So just occasional one-on-one matches or online, you're not, Okay.
Yeah. It's got to be tough to keep up that schedule. Like I mentioned, I've got like an 8-month-old, and it's like it's killed my playtime. I don't know how the hell you keep up with it, like being on the road.
What's your time divided like now, Kenny? Are you mostly in Japan?
Yeah, I mean, I'm about 80-20 in Japan, in Canada. And, yeah, like, in terms of game time, I can play once a week or so. So, as much as I would love to say I'm ready for CEO and what it has to, type of players that will be there in attendance, I'm using this as actual, this is crunch time. This is me getting my practice in for the big dance, so.
Okay. Your practice base.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a warm-up.
Do you travel with consoles?
Yes. Always.
Nice. How's that work in Japan? Do you have to have converters or like the power stuff? I've never taken American electronics over to Japan.
Usually, like, the games case becomes, that's like, you know, the monitor all built in deal. That's invaluable for me when I'm traveling.
But, oh shit.
Man, this guy's too good. I can't, hard to talk to him.
Yeah, sorry.
Oh!
Keep talking, keep
okay,
talking.
Okay, all right.
Keep talking, all right.
He paid me off.
Oof. Jesus.
You win.
Wow.
Kenny, I think both of us have spent some time in Eldon, Missouri.
Why ever were you in Eldon, Missouri?
Because I grew up in Kansas, and I was friends with Harley Race's granddaughter, and used to go out to his old WLW shows, so
yeah.
I've been to a bunch of those shows. Yeah,
aside from like a Chinese buffet, I can't imagine anything else actually being there.
Yep. I was just talking to Curtis Axel about this. Were you, did you guys overlap at all in Eldon?
No. I've only been there once, and it's not that I vowed not to return or whatever, but there's really been no reason to ever come back.
No. I think Harley Race is the only thing that's happening in Eldon, Missouri.
And probably still, to this day, the only thing that's happened, right?
I would imagine, yeah.
The local legend. He's like, it's his town, really.
Yeah. Legendary barbecues when the guys come to town.
Here we go. Now it's done.
How you feeling, Jason?
Real good.
Yeah?
Just great.
Is it going well so far?
That one didn't.
Oh, you're good, man. You're good.
Is your title the face of wrestling?
That's my title. Yeah.
Okay. I have to call you that now?
He's the heel of wrestling.
Okay. Living legend. So I've not played much of 5. Cody is not in this, right?
Cody is not.
No, not yet.
Okay. Has he been talked about? Like, have they announced him or anything as DLC?
No,
they haven't even really rumored any Season 2 characters or whatever.
Huh.
Ouch, 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 fuck. Alright, yep, there it is, fucker. I was waiting for that.
Oh, no.
No, get under.
Shit.
Oh. That was good. 1-1. 1-1.
Yeah.
He's a showman.
Okay.
He's a showman.
Kenny
that's
or
exactly,
the character?
That's exactly why I pick Alex.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
He's got the ability to be a showman. I'm trying to woo the
crowd.
That's
fucking okay.
That's
shit.
Important.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Kenny, let me have that first one.
Winning is so very secondary to me. It's about putting on a show.
Yeah. Thank you very much. I try and say that to Dan, but he'll win one round and then walk away from the sticks and then run around the office proclaiming himself the victor.
You're very anti-trash talk, though, which I've never understood.
No.
Fighting games are hand-in-hand with trash talk.
I like trash talk just fine, but you make shit personal.
Oh.
Personal.
I think you're a pretty good guy.
See? He's bullshitting right now.
I like him.
I mean, he really believes that.
Jason, who is your main in this game, if you had one?
I mean, I can play Nash okay.
Yeah?
But that's it. I mean, I'm not really showing that off right now. But, you know. I've moved around a little bit to, like, to Birdie and Guile a little bit when he came out.
Who's your showiest character?
I'm not a showy guy, Dan.
Okay. You never get that urge?
Nope.
Okay.
Oh. Yep.
Oh!
Get in. Oh, I wanted it. Oop.
Oh.
Now he's bringing out the stand jab tech.
Is this supposed to be the same airport as the Guile 1
nice.
Thing 2?
Yeah, actually.
Same lady doing the fist pump?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Thanks for letting me. Okay, well, that was a good warm-up for you, I'm sure, but Kenny, I'm gonna have to pass you off. You've made it to the next round.
Oh, the final boss.
No. You're going down a level here.
I'm in loser side now.
Okay.
You were already there.
I knew Ryu. Yeah. I know how to do a hadouken.
You've got a mean Ken.
And dragon punch.
You've got a mean Ken. Go to end.
We should end the battle, right?
Yeah. All right. So Jason, you have the standard setup here. I've never played with this weird
stick.
All
the punches are on the top and the kicks are on the bottom.
Is this the three and the three? Yeah,
it is the three and the three.
But you don't really do that in this one, do you?
Like
the ultras aren't with three?
No, you don't have to, but there are some instances that you need three punches with three kicks.
I really have barely played this one.
So I've got to ask, just out of curiosity, as someone that put in hundreds of hours in Ultra Street Fighter 4,
yeah.
What's your opinion on 5?
I really like the core engine an awful lot. I think it's super fun to play, man. And
it's a fantastic fighting engine. It's so good.
I like my options when I'm getting up. I like frame traps and stuff. I'm not very good at them, but I just like the flow of this game. I don't want to say better than 4. It's different and it's fun and it's a shame that there's such negative connotations surrounding this game.
I totally agree.
The single player content, and a lot of people overlooked it, and they're not going to come back to it probably. But
I think the reason why there is such negative connotations is because people actually do love the game, and it's just that they want more out of what they love already.
Oh yeah, totally. I mean, Street Fighter is a storied franchise. Like, this is the cream of the crop. Yes. This is, you know, the premier fighting game. So yeah, it's a little staggering to see that kind of, I don't know, step backwards, I guess, for them.
Right. I think once we see the full roster, you know, the engine is the way it is, you know, full stages, night and day cycle, they're going to love this game all over.
Those are really cool. Yeah, I got to spend quite a bit of time with the story mode, actually. I played through most of it. Oh boy, here we go. Damn, it's very fragile, that stick.
You handed it to me.
I know.
Ooh.
I don't know why I did.
This stuff.
You don't know what you're gonna get in pools.
I'm not gonna brag if I win, though. That's not my style.
No,
God damn it.
That's not your style at all.
Sportsman.
Ooh.
See? Who does that? Jesus Christ.
I love it. Say what you will, but I love it.
Oh, shit.
Oh, what?
Oh.
Oh.
He was trying to be showy there.
Was he?
Yep.
Oh, God. Hold my own.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Nice.
I lost fair and square.
You're goading.
You brought
me right
the fight, though. I love your style. I love your style.
It's a really obnoxious one.
No.
So, Kenny, do you think you're sticking with Alex as your main? I saw you playing Mika for a while as well.
I was. Upon release, Mika was the more relatable pro wrestler.
Yep.
Now that Alex is out, I feel that he's more my style.
It seems
more like the type of style that I want to play. Ooh.
He's taunting. I don't think he knew how he did that.
I knew exactly what I was doing.
Best of three. You gotta keep
going. Best of three?
Yeah,
okay.
Best of three.
Same characters?
Sure.
You can switch up if you want.
I'll be Ryu.
I want to see you play Ken.
You want me to be Ken? Okay.
Yeah.
Totally different moveset.
Totally, yeah. Well, kind of.
Yeah.
Anyway.
What's his V trigger?
I tried to tell you for like a half hour one day, and you still don't get it, so I'm done.
Do I have to go to end if I want to be Ken?
Yeah.
Okay. Kenny, do you have a like particular affinity for Capcom? I know your Twitter handle has Mega Man in it.
Right.
And obviously Street Fighter.
Your intro music.
And Mega Man's entrance music, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for quite some time, actually. I was using a remixed version of Dr. Wily's Castle from Mega Man 2.
Nice.
And
get hit start.
Capcom Japan, in fact, had come across the fact that I was using it. They got their sound team to make me like a customized version of it.
Oh, nice.
Just for me. Awesome.
Kenny, if I could we have you move the mic a little bit closer to you?
Yes.
You're cutting out a little bit, so.
No problem.
Thank you. Got one
still
of them.
Got me?
Yeah, I was like, I got you.
A little more loud than before?
Yeah.
Okay, great.
I keep expecting Capcom to come down on this local promotion around here called Hood Slam, where it's they've got Street Fighter characters and everything, like, frequently.
Yeah, you know,
dude, it's really rad.
Yeah. Hey, I was waiting for you. I've seen some of their highlights. I'd like to say Botchamania.
Oh, yeah. I think they used to advertise on Botchamania.
Yes, that makes sense. Yes.
Yep. Yeah, they had M. Bison and Cammy and even like Mega Man one time.
The Street Fighter and Mortal Kombat characters, and Dan told me, I didn't catch this at one of the shows, but you know, in Street Fighter, when you shoot projectiles towards one another, they clash, right? But in Mortal Kombat, they go through one another. And it reflects that in the ring. So like you do like a Hadouken in the ring, right? If somebody else did that in that wrestling promotion, it would block, right? But they were two Mortal Kombat characters one time, and they both shot something, and then they both fell over.
Yeah, they adhere to the rules.
Little details
like
that.
Attention to detail, yeah. Yes.
See? Oh, geez.
Wow.
Yep.
Look at this guy.
Damn it.
Uh-oh.
Jason, how do I do his ultra when I have it?
There you go. You did it.
That wasn't
that was it. That was it.
No.
That was it.
I was doing so well for a while. Damn it. Listen, that went south pretty quick.
Yeah, but really, I mean, that's the character. I think you had it firmly in your grasp, and I just got one lucky hit in, and thus began the downward descent.
Yeah. He got in your head.
Yeah.
So really,
mind game.
No. You had that one won.
Alex is super cool. I want to give him more of a shot.
I've never been in. Was he on the original roster?
Alex?
What?
Yeah,
no,
he was the first DLC.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I've not played as him. Yep. That'll do it.
Good stuff.
Back to you, Jason.
I'll hop back in. So is Jabali set up like a training center at his place there tonight, or?
I mean, he's got like three or four consoles going at all times. And
nice.
We got Overwatch downstairs, Street Fighter V, Street Fighter IV, and then Street Fighter V up here. So
nice.
There's a lot going on, but of course they're hard at work as well, because there's a lot of final preparations.
This is a big-ass tournament to put on. He put on a really, really good show. We'll talk to him in a little bit as well.
Yeah.
Have you played much Overwatch?
I have purposely not played any of it because I'm scared to get addicted.
Definitely happened to me. It's really, really good.
Yeah.
That's
you see, like, I've already fallen behind. There are things that I've wanted to play and haven't had a chance to. I've wanted to play the new Dark Souls. I still haven't played Metal Gear 5.
Oh, no.
Put aside like 100 hours if you want to play that one.
Yeah, I haven't played Uncharted yet either.
It's a great one.
Neither have I.
Uh-oh. Oh, that's not good.
Uh-oh.
I don't know what's happened. Okay, well, we'll redo this. We're okay. Nice.
Yeah,
I mean, like, I've been playing... I've known I've been going to go to CEO for quite some time. It was to the point where when we did our contract negotiations, I had to write out this time off to come here. And the last thing I wanted to do was come here, embarrass myself, embarrass pro wrestlers, and people that I've wanted
Woods
to.
Woods is already doing a great job of that.
Oh, what the?
We're getting dropped.
What the dickens?
You know, Woods said he was requesting time off to come to PAX East to face me in the main event of PAX Mania, and then he couldn't do it. He backed out.
Yeah. Anime convention.
That's Woods. Kenny's here. Kenny's playing.
Yep.
Woods backed
out. I'm here. I'm man of my word.
Mm-hmm. Not like Woods.
I've come from an honorable country and an honorable promotion of New Japan Pro Wrestling. So a guy like Xavier Woods, it rolls off his shoulder to not keep his promises.
Right. It's nothing new.
That's just like another day.
Nothing.
Exactly. It's just another day at the office where he tells a lie. But me, here I am.
Yeah.
I'm going to change it up.
I actually can be pretty awesome.
I think he was the first one that I fell in love with. We went to an event before the game was released, and this is the first character that I saw, and he's just modeled so well.
Guess what?
What's up?
Austin Creed's character.
Oh.
Dave Woods plays Birdie.
Oh, wow.
This could potentially be a tune-up match for a fantasy match that Kenny Omega versus Xavier Woods. Never happened, but I live vicariously from time to time.
Oh, to see you guys put out a parody shirt, like the Elite put out a New Day parody shirt.
See, that was never my, that was not my idea, actually, so I can't take any credit for that. But, yeah, it came out, and it was instantly, like, the top seller for us at Beat.com.
Ouch. Ooh. Ah. I was expecting to throw there. Oh, shit.
What?
I think I hit the wrong button.
Oh, how did I mess that up?
This is tense.
Oh, just out of range.
Oh, boy. Oh
boy! Round two.
Fight. Nice. Ooh. Is Alex a alpha character?
No, Street Fighter 3.
3, okay. 3 is probably the one I played the least.
Shit. Oh no. Them traps. It's called a frame trap, Dan.
Oh, right.
Yep.
Wasn't the original release of 3, it was mostly just Ken and Ryu and then a lot of new characters?
Yeah.
You brought in Chun Li or something, right?
Whoa. Oh shit. This is not looking good, Dan.
I believe in you, Jason.
I don't. No, I wanted to jump there, Kenny. Why wouldn't you let me jump?
Jerk.
No.
This is not going great.
No. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay. I'm going to mash something out. No, I didn't fucking do... That was going to be sweet. I was going to do the headbutt after that, and it was going to hit, and I was going to go into super.
Ultra?
Fuck.
Yeah.
Sounds great.
Fuck.
See, when Alex gets a corner, he's so difficult to deal with. So
I had trouble getting out of that corner.
Yeah, with Birdie, it's almost game over. But you did a fantastic job.
For a little bit.
Are there any other fighting game series that you're particularly into, Kenny? Mortal Kombat, Tekken, Soul Calibur?
I love Soul Calibur around the GameCube of it.
Yeah.
I love playing Link.
Yeah, yeah.
That was cool.
It was weird having projectiles in that game.
Yeah. Really into Tekken 3. It's like, once I started going to Japan, the level to play it casually was too high.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone's so good. It just became daunting and kind of scary to even try.
He's on to me. Nice! You son of a bitch. Oh, that was really good. Ah, damn it. Oh, yeah, that breaks.
Yeah, good. Armor break.
This is good because I haven't really played against any Alexes. I'm learning stuff. Thanks to Kenny Omega.
Is it fair to say you guys are kind of evenly matched here?
No.
No?
Nice.
Oh shit. That hurts a lot. That was good. Shade the T-Hawk there.
It's like a razor's edge.
Yeah.
Oh, he knows his moves.
Yeah. That was dumb, Jason. I have V-Trigger. You know what I haven't been doing? I know. I haven't been eating burgers. Jason. I haven't been throwing bananas.
Yeah, more cans, more bananas. Yeah, you gotta eat more.
I gotta eat more.
Yeah.
I gotta keep my strength up. Let's run that back.
Yep.
Now that I remember all of my moves.
Yes. And those are the most important ones, actually.
They really are.
You're sticking with Birdie?
Yes.
Yeah?
Till I die. Round one. Till I lose one more. Fight. Then it's over. See?
Yep.
Yeah. That's...
Nice.
Oop. No! Yep.
Do something showy, Jason.
Well, I just got fucking hit four times. That's fucking showy, and I'm not stunned yet. There we go. But I took like eight of those to the face. Mmm. Pick throws in the whole bit. Oh.
Nice.
You should jump at me more so I can, like, headbutt you. That would be helpful, Kenny.
Have you won any yet?
Oh, here we go.
No, that's a genuine question.
Here we go. I don't know.
Okay.
Actually.
All right.
It's not about winning, Dan.
Right.
It's
right.
About making Kenny look good.
Right.
We gotta prep him for CEO.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah.
Yep. See, that's what I want.
Oh, that's not gonna work.
Oh.
Oops.
Ah.
Oh, nice.
I called it too. No!
Don't go anywhere!
No, shit.
Okay.
Oh, there's not much pushback on that. No. I'm gonna just... Here we go! Oh, damn it. That was it. That was gonna be my moment. Ah! Shit. Yep. Look at it. Oh!
What does it mean when he's red?
Dan, he just parried my soda can, by the way.
Oh, jeez.
I just wanted to let you know.
It's the worst. What's happening when he's red?
Here, I'm going to throw the chain. Go get him. Oh, damn it.
Like Ivy?
Get in there. What? Yes, he's
like Ivy's whip.
He threw my jab. I jabbed it. I pressed a button.
Oh. Sorry, bud.
Thanks, man. Kenny's pretty fucking good.
He seems pretty good.
Here, why don't you play him again?
Okay.
I got to recoup.
Here, tell me a character that I maybe haven't played as that I should check out. Although, wait, I like that Rashid guy. He's the new guy, right?
Yeah, you can mash stuff.
Yeah,
up.
With yeah, the Google yeah, Glass,
yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, do a bunch of fireball motions. And
okay,
stuff.
Fireball
yeah.
motions.
Yeah.
Any dragon punch stuff?
I don't remember. I don't think so.
I think it's the backwards Hadouken motion is the one you want to rely on.
Hurricane kick.
Okay.
I've pressed it three times.
Right. Yeah, hurricane kick because it was the eagle kick, and then the tornado move where he spins a lot. I think that was punches. I think.
Okay. And his V trigger is that tornado kick, right?
Yeah.
No, it's just an actual tornado.
Oh, right. Okay. Oh, right.
Yeah.
All right, that will be him.
Kenny, talk to me about anime. I'm serious.
Yeah.
I'm dead serious. I used to be a big fan of anime. It's been a long time.
I feel bad that I haven't really been speaking to you guys about anything that you brought up. You brought up that Capcom question. I guess I'm a Capcom fan. I was so excited as of Resident Evil 7. I played the hell out of the demo, thinking that I'd be the first one to ever beat it. That didn't go so well.
Oh, yeah?
RE7?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Now, my theory from the beginning of it all, I think it has to do, of course, there's a specific order you have to do everything.
Right.
That goes without saying. I think somehow it has to do with the time on the wall clock.
On the wall clock?
Okay. Yes, it's a wall clock, and it just seems to stick out a little too much to...
Hmm. I know there's two different endings, and we both did it at E3 with the VR headset. And we know there's two different endings, one where you go upstairs and one where you go out the back door. I didn't see
anything. There's even two different, apparently there's different sets of endings upstairs on the phone as well.
Oh, really?
Okay.
Yeah. One where if you go there directly, and another if you go there after you get the axe.
Weird, okay.
The conversation on the phone is different.
Ah. Okay, great. Yep, this is going well. All right.
I was feeling it for a little while.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
But it's been proven that there are ghost sightings in the house as well.
Really?
And I've heard that there are up to, I think, 4 to 7 ghost sightings. So I think perhaps if you find them all in a specific order, it unlocks something.
This almost sounds like PT stuff, like, you know, rumored secrets and things.
It totally is.
I totally got a PT vibe playing that game. Did you as well?
I didn't actually get a chance to play PT. It was gone before I had a chance to do it.
It plays a lot like RE7, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally.
And I don't know if the actual... I mean, do you think the full experience is going to be first person?
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be a full first-person game. Because they said the whole thing will be VR if you want it to be.
And you can switch back and forth on the fly.
But I mean, like, even Code Veronica had that mode where there was the first person.
That's true.
Actual game was third.
Oh,
I don't know. I think it'd be cool if there was a third-person option.
Yeah. Although, did you like six at all? I know most people did not at all.
Six and five were some of the most fun I've had as a couch co-op experience.
Six, really?
Yes.
Wow. I liked five a lot co-op, but I was not big on six.
The reason why, the one thing I hated about six were the chase scenes where the camera goes all wonky and you have no idea where you are on the screen. That was almost game breaking. But I love, it wasn't called Raid, was it?
Which one?
Raid mode?
The raid mode or survival, not survival mode.
Was whatever that like the mercenaries mode?
Yes, mercenaries.
Yeah, mercenaries is great.
Love mercenaries. So good. Ah. And I put tons of time into Revelation mercenary mode as well.
Oh, nice. Ugh. Yeah, I don't know. I was not big on six, so while I didn't really like what I played a seven, I think it's more interesting than if they had kept going down the route they went with six, but I guess we'll see once the full game comes out.
Where do you think they went wrong with six, in your opinion?
I think it went too far away from what made Resident Evil Resident Evil. I don't think it doesn't all need to be tank controls, you know, in a mansion. Because I thought four was incredible. Four is one of my favorite games ever.
Yeah. Me too.
And then five was really good. Definitely co-op. And then six, I thought, just went too far into kind of just generic action set piece stuff.
It seemed like three different teams made the three separate stories, and it didn't mesh well together.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah, I didn't even like it enough to like play through it. I got to the second set of characters, and I was like, you know what, I'm not really having fun here, and I stopped. But yeah, seven, I'll give it a shot for sure.
Oh yeah, I'm not only will I give it a shot, but I'm excited to give it a shot. I'm looking very forward to it.
I think I'm ready for.
Did you like Revelation
on Resident Evil?
Yeah, I thought Revelations was all right. I like that better than six. That one they put on 360.
That was
Xbox
good.
One, the Barry Burton daughter one.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Did you get the true ending?
No.
Oh, it's so worth getting the true ending. It makes it a complete package. Yeah, awesome. Yeah.
Cool.
See, now you're.
We were.
Are you a Guile player? Because
traditionally, yeah. Like I played him a lot in four. Actually, Rose is who I mained like from start to finish. You know, and it was from Mike Ross's inadvertent inspiration. He told me when Street Fighter 4 first came out that Rose was garbage, and I was determined to prove him wrong.
Right. She is not garbage.
She is not garbage. Good. She's so good.
Okay. Oh, good.
Round one. Fight.
Did people like Juri from four?
Yeah,
I liked her a lot.
I think so.
She's one of my favorites in that.
That thing's scary.
Kenny, as a Mega Man fan, are you at all interested in Mighty Number 9?
No.
That's probably the right reaction.
Not at all. I was disgusted in that game.
Have you played it at all yet?
No. I don't have to. I knew right away that it wasn't going to be good.
Yeah, the reactions have not been great.
A game that I actually really enjoyed, I haven't played the full version of, is Gunvolt. I think that's more true to what Mega Man wanted to become.
Yeah, the 3DS one, the Mighty Gunvolt.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
So good.
I also like the Mega Man 9 and 10 they made a few years ago.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, yeah. It's very true to Mega Man.
I felt that 9 kind of brought back the spirit of Mega Man more so than 10 did.
Yeah.
But I mean, 10 was it's a true entry to the series, I think.
Yeah.
I think it's about time to get a new real Mega Man game. I'm sure Capcom was probably waiting for the folly that was Mighty Number 9. I think they have something ready in stock. They're just waiting for an Alpha Nate to make a fool of himself.
I, I've kind of stopped getting excited about Mega Man proper from Capcom because I just don't know how invested they are in that character or, you know, doing what Mega Man fans want. Because we haven't seen that for a long time from them.
Well, I mean, from my friends at the Japanese office of Capcom, they still believe that he is the one true mascot.
Oh, really?
Of Capcom. They believe that even though they're relying completely, they're 100% all in with Monster Hunter right now.
And it's hard to deny that, too. It's just huge over there.
It's made them so much money, especially overseas in Japan. They still look at Mega Man. It's their most prized intellectual property.
Man, you wouldn't know it by the output of the last few years.
I know. This is why I'm surprised. But they said that, I don't even know if I'm about to say this, but because Inafune was the creator of Mega Man.
I think we know that. It's okay. Like, people know that. It's not a secret.
But because of that, though, they wanted him to have the first crack at a Mega Man-styled game before they went back up to bat with it.
Huh.
So that's why I think Capcom will probably respond now with something of their own. I think. But who knows, right?
I would be very happy if they did.
Yeah, me too. I would support it. I'm too big of a fan. I'll support anything. And I'll like it. Damn it. Oh!
That's showy.
That was showy, yeah. Mm-hmm. That was a backbreaker, yeah.
Kenny, do the wrestlers over there still go to Ribera when you're in Japan?
Of course.
I went to both Riberas a couple years ago, and it was pretty delicious.
Yeah, it's really good. I went there actually just recently, but because a fan wanted to see what the fuss was about. He had heard stories about everyone going to Ribera. Still good. It's still, you know, regarded as the wrestler place.
Yeah.
It's fun just to be in there because of all the old pictures. It's like being a part of history.
Yeah, they're even up on the ceiling, I noticed.
Yeah, they're everywhere. There's too many.
Oh, shit. I can shoot little sonic booms when I pop my V-trigger.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. You didn't get to see it there.
No? No. Hey, you'll have to show me here.
Oh, maybe. I don't want to be too flashy or anything.
Yeah.
Oops.
You're a modest man.
Yeah, I am.
Ow. Really.
Oh, this is bad. Ah. Nope.
Ooh.
Oh, no. Oh, my stance fell. Nope. Kenny falls for that once. Once. Never again. One! Aha!
Is that a throw, just that giant chest chop he does?
Yes.
That's great.
All right, here we go. See? Little son.
Okay. Yeah, that went great.
There's more Sonic Booms that come out. Actually.
Okay.
Yeah, I think you can throw up to 7 or something.
But sometimes people just like jump up and.
Yeah, that's pretty rude.
Talk you.
Yeah. That's kind of rude.
What a jerk. That...
Oh, God.
Here, you take it.
I'm confused every time you hand me this because there are no labels whatsoever. And what, are we playing on PlayStation?
Go to End Battle? Yeah, okay. This is a.
These are start and select here?
Yes.
Okay.
So start's going to be on the right hand side.
Gotcha.
How long have you been trying to get to CEO, Kenny? Like, I've heard you talking about it for a while.
Now, I didn't know how big of a fan really was of wrestling up until last year when I had seen, you know, how much wrestling-related stuff there was.
He's had the ring, the cage, yeah, all the belts, of course.
Yeah, yes. This is this year's belt.
Yep.
Does that go to the winner?
Yeah, I think there's a build for every winner. Oh, shucks.
You get disconnected?
So far, yeah.
4K.
Good job. You found that button.
Yeah. Learning.
So ever since I had seen the show last year, year. I really wanted to be a part of some sort of CEO if the opportunity.
Was it last year or the year before that, God, who was it that got featured on like ESPN? Because everybody was doing like...
K-Brad. Stone Cold K-Brad.
Yes, that's right. Yeah, everybody. I think I even sent that to you. But yeah, everybody's doing like, you know, wrestling intros.
Oh, I saw the Taker entrance where the lights went down. Yep. And
Yeah. Snake Eyes is just
yeah,
like...
Yeah, it's Dominion,
That was good.
Dominion, right. Oh, man. I haven't been the CEO, I think, since like 2011. I was living down in Atlanta at the time, so it was a little easier to get to.
Wait, so is it in Atlanta?
No, it's in Florida. It's in Orlando.
Oh, okay, right.
Kenny, don't eat too much Popeyes. For sure. It's right across
Everyone
the street.
Everyone has warned me about that. Is that just like a thing here?
It's right across the street, so it's easily accessible.
But tasty?
Yeah. I mean, it's a fast food chain for the most part. I don't know why it's...
And chicken, right? It's like, it's chicken.
There's some chicken.
Popeyes, yeah.
They got some... Oh, the biscuits?
It's Louisiana fast.
The biscuits are pretty good. But yeah, it's a kind of a surreal experience. You know, there's this like this whole like line of like it's like Gamer B is ordering, you know, fast food chicken in Orlando, Florida. It's a fun thing to see.
No.
Yep.
I hate that.
He's not done. Oh.
German suplex. Oh god. In the lore, is he a wrestler?
Nice.
Damn it.
Alex?
I'm done. Yeah.
I don't know.
He's gotta be. He's got a German suplex. He's doing chops and
Oh, yeah, he's a wrestler.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
I don't
I'm
know
still doing story. My due diligence. I'm representing wrestling.
Attaboy. I didn't get to play much of 3. Were you a fan of Alex back then?
Third Strike?
Yeah.
Third Strike, I played a Koopa, actually.
Okay. Not Chun-Li, not Ken.
No, never went top tier. But the thing is, I didn't really understand even the engine with First Strike. I didn't even know you could parry until I played someone that played competitively.
And you're like, what the hell is he doing? He's
exactly
he's blocking my shit.
Is that Third Strike with the super famous Evo thing with all the parries of Chun-Li's kicks?
That's the one. Yes.
Okay. All right.
Why don't you go one more time?
All right.
And then I think. I don't know. My ego's broken and bruised.
I didn't have much one to begin with, so I'm
no,
all right.
Not at all. Not at all.
Jason, as modest as you are, if you were a professional wrestling or a wrestler, which one would you be? Who's the most modest pro wrestler of all time?
Jericho.
Yeah, Jericho's pretty modest.
I think he's pretty modest.
Kind of like a hardcore Holly. He never had too much to say.
Hardcore Holly?
You know,
he wasn't a flashy guy. He just, you know, Alabama slam people.
He was a bully, though.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Are you a bully?
No, I'm not, actually.
No?
Why are you perpetuating shit like this?
Kind of a bully, but. Yeah.
I am not a bully. Yeah. What the hell?
How's your Alabama slam?
It speaks for itself. I'm not a... This is why Dan and I get along so well.
We used to work at Game Informer together before we came here.
We've known each other.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
But no, Dan likes to perpetuate rumors whenever he's on camera. So now the internet's going to think I'm a bully.
I'm the modest one here.
Oh, nobody's going to fucking believe that.
That's going to be it.
That is totally going to be it.
All right.
Kenny, is Bailey around? I mean, he's probably like 3 feet away waiting for the opportunity.
Yeah, he was peeking. He kept peeking inside the door and he's like, is it my time yet? I can call him.
Tell him not going to buy a timeshare or anything, but he can come on and pimp his stuff.
Okay. Give me a sec.
All right. That Bailey's an entrepreneur.
What does he sell?
Anything. His soul.
Like cars or what?
No.
No? What does he sell? Like subscription Twitch stuff or?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah?
Probably.
Merch?
He makes enough to buy that statue and all those belts and all those figures in the back.
I know belts are expensive.
He's doing well for himself.
All right, I can
obviously.
Tell.
No, he used to work at Iron Galaxy for a little bit.
Okay. He worked for Lang?
Oh, no!
Oh,
God damn it!
Oh.
Jim Bailey!
Give me that. Get on the chair.
I'm sorry.
Out of my
room.
What
have you done?
Go.
I'm sorry, don't hurt me. Don't hit me anymore.
But
go to your room, Kenny.
Oh man.
God, Alec. God
hey guys,
damn it, Alex. He flew all this way. He's been trying to go to CEO for God knows how many years. And you finally make his dream come true, only to just hit him upside the head with a chair.
It was a ruse.
That was actually, no, that was real. I don't know how to hold my punches, so. Yeah,
man.
Trust me, we're going to be doing a lot of fun stuff this weekend, but how are you guys doing?
Doing great. Yeah, Kenny humbled us. I got one win, so I'm proud about that. I'm going to take that.
Awesome. He's been an awesome guest so far, to be honest. I'm really excited he's here, so. We're gonna have some fun this weekend. Are you guys done playing, or you want to play a match?
I think we're done. I'm not playing against you. I know it. Bruce yeah, what's Eagle, up? Alrighty, talk to me about CEO. So that's going on this weekend.
So CEO,
how many games you have going on?
Yeah, we have a lot of games going on. Smash is some of the biggest turnouts in Smash history coming down to CEO.
Yeah, it's great.
We got Mortal Kombat. We got Street Fighter V. We got Tekken 7 being shown there as part of the Tekken Tour. Capcom's really a premier event, so a lot of sponsor support, which humbles me because, you know, from the small event it was 6 years ago where we had 300 people, no sponsor dollars, no, you know, no support, just the community coming out to have fun.
I remember
and now to
days.
Be one of the biggest supported events is it's been awesome. So a lot of pressure, you know, I want to make everyone happy, have a good time, but it's second nature to me. I love to do this. I love to have events. And now that I have the proper staff, that's been amazing helping put everything together. It puts less stress on me to have more fun and entertain more people. So
absolutely. Yeah.
Bringing down Kenny, who's a big fan of Street Fighter. He was actually keeping up with me earlier. He was doing pretty good. So, hey, you know,
that's keeping fun. Up or bodying.
Yeah,
you
he was. Yeah, he was just keeping up. Anyways, so yeah, CEO excited. Down here in Orlando, we sold over 3,000 tickets already. So it's gonna be pretty big. 25 plus countries are coming. You know, it's awesome to have people come from all over the world because my goal is just to have people meet each other for the passion of fighting games. So I'm excited.
You guys put on a great event. So we'll be checking it out via Twitch, I'm sure. You guys will be streaming, I take it. Absolutely.
Yep. Yeah. One of these, we have 9 streams actually going on this weekend.
Jesus.
So
that's great.
If you go to, you know, cogaming.org, just click CO 2016. There's the stream schedule, all the information you need. That's already up. We just released an album on SoundCloud. You can look up soundcloud.com/CO2016. So
sell it, man. Do it.
No, it was community driven. So if it does well, then yes, we'll definitely look at selling it. But Kenny was rocking one of the shirts. We'll probably put on sale online after the event. And just happy you get to put it on. I hope the Giant Bomb guys, like Jeff and all you guys, can come out sometime. Be awesome to have you.
It's been a long time since I've been there, actually. Yeah, I think 2011 I was there.
And that was the first year in the hotel where I was just figuring out how to run a hotel event. And lots changed.
You were running around like a madman that weekend.
Yeah, I still am going to be, because now that was just one ballroom. Now there's 4 ballrooms of CEO.
Good
so,
God.
One's a big arcade room. We got DDR machines, Jubeat machines. Initial D racing machine's going to be there, so because I know a lot of us love more than just fighting games. So,
sure.
I'm going to be running around like a madman. I already actually it's been kind of relaxing, so everything's kind of taking care of itself right now.
All right, well, you take care of Kenny this weekend, please.
I will.
And thanks for putting on the event. Thanks for setting this up for us. Can we
not
talk
a problem.
To Kenny again? Is he okay?
Yeah, sure. Let me bring
Is
back Kenny. All right.
He's
all right.
Probably.
Yeah, Kenny should be okay. I put a Band-Aid on his forehead. What a loser.
Thank you, Jubeo.
There you go. You're welcome, guys. Thank you.
Oh man,
this is rough.
Yeah.
You hate to see this.
Oh,
I know.
Boy.
Oh boy.
Oh.
Jeez.
Wow, do I ever have a headache?
This is how we do it.
Hey,
in America.
Guys.
Hey there.
How you doing after that vicious attack?
Yeah.
It's unfortunate, really.
Yeah, it is reprehensible.
I can't believe it. Kenny, it was super cool talking to you, man. Like,
yeah,
we know you're a huge fan of gaming, and frankly, I wish we could have had Jeff on the show, and you guys could have just, you know, talking about shopping for games in Japan. That would have been killer.
Ever go to Super Potato?
Of course.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. The first time I went there, I think I dropped probably about $500.
Oh wow.
So. Yeah, it was quite a bit. I really stocked up.
Nice.
But I just go there for fun. Like, if there's ever time to kill, and you know, it's a stop in between stops, and it's such an easy way to kill. You know, half hour, an hour.
Yeah.
Just fun. You know, walk up and down. See. Sometimes you find some gems that, you know, things that weren't released in the West, but look like they'd be great titles to play. I'm still finding stuff. Just the other day, it was on one of the rare lists. It was called. Point-and-click adventure called Dead of the Brain. Looks so good.
Wow, huh. never heard of that.
Yeah, it's it was. This shouldn't be too surprising, but I mean, it was
influenced a lot by the Romero movies.
Oh, sure.
And, yeah. And apparently they are very highly rated. There are English patches available if you download the related version.
Mm-hmm. Huh.
Of course.
Those are out there. We don't necessarily condone them, but we've heard of it.
I never do such a thing.
I read about it on the internet once.
But I have heard that there is, there are these versions available. But I really would like to find the Japanese version and play that one too. It's got some good voice acting. It plays really cinematically. Anyway. That's neither here nor there. I'm just saying.
I have a feeling we could talk about shit like this for hours, and I would love to, but we got to call it, man.
Yeah, we got
to
go.
Best of luck to you this weekend. I will totally be tuning in and rooting for you, especially.
Yeah, I'm hoping to get on stream at some point.
I'm sure they'll put you on stream. I'm sure. I talked to Alex already. He's guaranteed it. So, Dan, thanks for hanging out with me.
Yeah, it was fun. Keep fighting the good fight against Austin Creed, please. Yeah. I will always be rooting for you anytime you're going up against Austin.
If it ever happens, it's good to know that I have fans out there that have my back.
Absolutely.
Yes. Totally have your back.
Thank you, Jason.
Well, thank you. Yeah. And thank you, Kenny.
Thanks for the games, guys. Yeah. Thanks. Really helping me warm up.
Thanks for letting me win one.
What's that?
Thanks for letting me win one. I'll take that.
You're keeping score?
No, it says it right there on the screen.
He's got a notepad here. There's a bunch of tallies down here on this notepad.
Why do you keep doing this? God damn it, I hate this.
Right here. You've been tallying how many times you've
just found that on the...
Yeah, just God. Make notes show up. Yeah.
All right. Sorry about that. Sorry you had to see that, Kenny. Anyway, thanks. Thanks for joining us. Good luck this weekend. I'm going to go... deal with this guy, I guess. And thanks for everybody for tuning in.
Yeah, thank you so much.
See you.